growing complexity of the food supply chain, as described in Module 1, has led to greater risk of food fraud or economically motivated adulteration within the supply chain, and therefore greater public health risk to the consumer and greater economic and brand risk to the producer, retailer, and importer. Companies have been responding to the supply chain complexity and increased awareness of food fraud to better protect their product, their brand, and their balance sheets. Some companies are increasing their ability to focus on it by significantly reducing the number of vendors they have approved, while others are implementing new or additional quality assurance methods.
As one example, after the melamine events in China and the United States, industry responded by developing new testing approaches for dairy proteins to try and prevent the cases of fraud. This also means that now food fraud is required in some audits, and it will be part of the GFSI standard. The GMA funded the A.T. Kearney study to better understand fraud. And they've also started a working committee on ways to identify fraud risks. The Global Food Safety Initiative initiated a food fraud think tank. They published a white paper on fraud, and they're incorporating fraud in their upcoming guidance. So agencies are taking action to prevent fraud, both regulatory and non-regulatory.
The FDA, the USDA, and the U.S. Department of Homeland Security jointly funded economically motivated adulteration research to better understand the nature of food fraud events and identify the warning signs at the University of Minnesota. European Union has funded a food integrity project. They are also sponsoring research on food fraud, and they're working on new regulations. The China Food Safety Law now includes food fraud provisions. The European Food Safety Authority strengthened horse passports after the adulteration of beef with horse. And the European Action Plan on Food Fraud has also led to the drafting of new regulations. In the U.S., the most notable event has been the Food Safety Modernization Act, or FSMA, which has brought major comprehensive changes to the Food, Drug, and Cosmetic Act as it focuses on prevention while also including stronger penalties. The preventative control rule provisions of FSMA explicitly deal with economically motivated adulteration, EMA. It requires that the risk of EMA be included in the hazard analysis that firms do. It places an emphasis on those things that have either happened before or could reasonably be expected to occur because of similar events in the past. If one protein product is suspect, then others could be, and it is focused on those things that pose a significant public health risk. Under FSMA, if there is a public health risk, you must implement preventative controls. There may be additional requirements in the intentional adulteration rule that the FDA will publish in 2016. Most companies must comply with this requirement by September 2016. Small firms get an extra year to 2017 if they have fewer than 500 employees, and very small firms, those that sell less than $1 million a year, or those that are covered by the pasteurized milk ordinance, have until 2018 to comply, although they do have to file paperwork that they are a very small firm by January 2016. The USDA is also considering fraud-specific rules.
The motivation for action is clear. It's required by regulations. It's required by your customers. It's expected by consumers. It's the trust they put in your firm. And in short, it's just good business to prevent food fraud. If they're cheating you, you're losing money. But most importantly, it protects public health.